ILTV Plus, your news from Israel and more 24/7. Start your free trial today. Subscribe at ILTV.tv and watch from any device.
Our top story tonight, the world reeling again amidst the latest coronavirus variant to make its rounds across the planet. And Israel among the nations already imposing new restrictions to mitigate the damages. Hannah Rifkin with the details.
נתחיל בחדשות וריאנט האומיקרון. הזן מתפשט בעוד ועוד מקומות בעולם ועוד מדינות מטילות הגבלות. אתמול בישיבת קבינט הקורונה הפעלנו צעדים מחמירים במטרה לשמור על ישראל מוגנת מבחוץ ופתוחה מבפנים. ככל שנדע יותר, נתאים ונדייק את הצעדים שלנו. מה שאני מבקש מהציבור זה סבלנות ומשמעת.
The so-called Omicron variant, first recorded in South Africa, now confirmed in multiple states, including dozens of cases here in Israel. And it's terrifying officials everywhere, as it boasts some 50 mutations overall, including 30 on the spike protein alone, which is the target for most vaccines. Also, this as the general infection rate in Israel already rising to 0.52%, some 7,400 people actively sick, and the death toll at 8,184. Among the new restrictions then, changes to international travel rules, chain of infection tracking, and Green Pass implementation, all set to take effect for 2 weeks, starting Sunday, November 28.
ישנם ענפים שנפגעים כמו התיירות והתעופה, ואנחנו נותנים על כך את הדעת. הכי חשוב, כשאנחנו עומדים בפני איום, צריך כמה שכבות הגנה. לנו יש חיסונים. אני מבקש מכולם, לכו להתחסן, זה שומר עליכם.
Now for the chain of infection tracking, the Israel Security Agency again authorized to track verified cases of the Omicron strain through patients' cell phones. As for Green Pass regulations, they'll now apply to closed spaces with over 50 guests, as opposed to a 100 guests minimum. And then for travel, the most sweeping changes. Israel listing no fewer than 50 African states as red countries, only North African nations like Egypt currently left off the list. And all foreign nationals from these countries will be barred entry for the next 14 days, save for those given permission by the Exceptions Committee. Anyone who's already arrived in Israel from these countries, meantime, are called upon to take a PCR test and enter quarantine for a week. And Israelis returning from these nations, even if vaxxed three times and even if returning through a third-party state, also required to undergo a week of isolation at a COVID hotel. They're released pending two negative PCR tests, and those who refuse to test must isolate for a full 2 weeks. As for travel to non-red nations, vaccinated Israelis must take a PCR test before their flights, then again upon landing, and then again after 72 hours quarantine. Unvaccinated Israelis, on the other hand, required to isolate for a full week, with their final PCR test taken on the seventh day. Israelis thankfully not too worried, though, the majority of travelers being vaccinated and more or less undisturbed by the new entry regulations.
I got back, I did a COVID test, I did the PCR test when I landed. I'm supposed to be in quarantine until I get my negative results. And that's it, I'm not too nervous about what's going on. I assume that I'm vaccinated, I had COVID already, so I think everything should be fine.
And finally, with respect to pending international events, Israeli authorities already making exceptions. The coming Miss Universe competition, for one, promising to hit the stage on schedule.
Miss Universe is going to be held through the Knesset of the Haredim. It's an event that is broadcast to 174 countries. It's a very important event, an event that even Eilat is looking for. And it's going to be held, of course, with all the rules of the event, with PCR tests, maybe every 48 hours. We will know how to control this event. So through the Knesset of the Haredim, there will be events like these and others that really... המדינה כבר התחייבה ואנחנו לא יכולים לבטל.